which is gang gang, namaste, and you know we up in here. So look, we're gonna see what the energy is like. I picked up on this download and it was like nigga naps. Here come nigga naps. It was like somebody making fun of somebody or something like that. I don't take it, I resonate. But there was like I was watching One More Chance and it like confirmed that, and I was like, okay. So it's like somebody hostile. I don't know. Take it, I resonate. Yeah, you're on your right path, you guys. Resonate Collective. But I had to cleanse myself. Walking away. Somebody's walking away from something. Yeah, ain't no sunshine when she's going to reverse. They realize that this was not their happiness. They're ending up a karmic cycle. They're ending a major cycle in their life. That's smart. I'm proud of you, Collective. Let me see. Yeah, false contract in reverse. They're going towards something that isn't a false contract. Let me see though. Angel. Yeah, they feel like they're looking at something like it's an angel and it's not a false contract. Like they know that's where they'd rather be. Mm-hmm. This is the second reading for the day. So take out resonate. Financial help. They look at it, yeah, gaining clarity over a situation, something that is their happiness. Okay, Divine Masculine. Now, Spirit is telling you to create a plan and that you're going to go viral with whatever this plan is that you're trying to implement. Or maybe you got like a new contract and you get into a 2 on the clock. Congratulations. Spirit, what is this new connections? It's something old that you dealt with because that was in reverse. Yeah, you don't want to hear whatever you walked away from. You don't feel like there's nothing to talk about. 220 on the clock, 2222. So you're in alignment walking away from this. Maybe I want to come back home. Spirit is telling you, save your money you ain't been saving. So you want to come back to somebody else. Somebody said, don't tell me what to do. Somebody was trying to tell somebody what to do. 2:52 on the clock. A Caucasian male or female. Caucasian male or female could be significant. He said, somebody get money with, not take it from me. Opening keys to new realms, so keep doing what you're doing, okay, Collective? Okay. Heart chakra is opened by love, healing, and emotional balance. The color for that is green. It's blocked by grief, loneliness, and emotional pain, okay? It's like repressed pain. The affirmation for that is I am loved and in touch with my emotions. Say it with me. I am loved and in touch with my emotions. I love it. Somebody has some controlling issues. They're a control freak or they're still in this controlling energy. You're reaping rewards. Your guardian angels are very much still around you. Yeah, black magic behind the scenes. Okay, maybe they caught this person doing black magic behind the scenes, which caused them to walk away. Yeah, stop beating yourself up. It's not your fault. Yeah, Divine Masculine. This is a warning. We got old pictures and videos. I regret everything. Spirit is saying what marriage, you want to marry this person? Yeah. So it's like, you got old pictures and videos and it's something that you regret really deep down inside, and regret could be stopping you from going towards what makes you happy. Because they say, you have the key to my heart. Surrender to divine plan. Somebody, you've been reminiscing about this a lot. 447. Make sure you're cleansing yourself because people has been doing dark magic behind the scenes. And if you're in low vibrational energy like anger, you know, sadness, regret, grief, shame. That's the lack mentality. It's easier for dark magic to cling on to you, okay? For them spells to stick. You're beautiful inside and out. Love yourself. So spirit is telling you, love yourself and walk away from this. I call the hang up before it rings. Yeah, they're looking at some wealthy female. Or maybe they're walking away from a wealthy female. Take it how it resonate. Okay? The root chakra, that's your seventh chakra. Your heart chakra is your fourth one, okay? It's opened by security, safety, and groundedness. It's blocked by instability, fear, and your basic needs not being met. Maybe this person was like trying to intimidate you so you wouldn't leave you, so you wouldn't leave, or like threaten you, like, well, I'm gonna expose you. I'm gonna expose your secrets if you stay, if you don't stay with me. Like, I don't know, but the affirmation for this is, I am grounded and secure. Say with me, I am grounded and secure. Or maybe this, the color for this is red. Or maybe this person was like, trying to dog another person. Root chakra, kundana, and this stuff was not, I don't know, whatever it is. Let go of doubt. Okay, somebody's watching your house. This is confirmation. Spirit is saying, let it play out in divine time. The answer is no, because there is a karmic involved. Okay, I love you and may always will. Yeah, storm coming, which is gonna make them learn their lesson learned, or like a storm is coming, which is gonna let them make them learn their lesson. Don't go in everybody else's home. They're gonna learn not to go in everybody's home too, and they'll probably see this person doing dark magic. Like, who knows? Reconciliation is here. Well, it's coming. Keep doing your shadow work. Keep prevailing. Or you got new contracts coming in, which you got a new that could be a reconciliation too. But with new contracts, okay? Because you got monitor spirits, or they got monitor spirits on them. Somebody here, you're pregnant with a spirit baby, or if you were to lay down, you're really fertile right now. Okay, or your spirit babies are protecting you in the physical realm, okay? Or you have spirit babies. A black male and female, 666. Social media, they watching you. Because the old them is dead and gone. Death and resurrection. I see and feel you when you cry. Don't cry, I'm always here. Your ancestors want you to know that. This is going to be a love for eternities as well. They're very enlightened. Or this storm is going to very much enlighten them. They got some wise advice, or they've been getting wise counsel. They're going to ask you to travel. When bad shit happens to somebody close to you, it's me. Their intentions aren't pure, okay? That means they had something cooking up for you, and your spirit team stepped in. Stop carrying everybody else's burdens. Focus on you and your healing. Yeah, this is a person that carries everybody else's burdens. And you know what? This person, where they were at, they probably were the financial health, because financial health came out. Yeah, I have so many drafted texts for you. This risk gonna change your life. Do it. Take this leap of faith. Only you will know what this is. Okay, Spirit, anything else? Let go of the past that's holding you back. Yeah, this could be somebody new that's in the picture, and you're looking back in the past, and you think it's a past lover, and this is a new lover. But, or this could be that decision I was talking about, where you got old love and new love here, because somebody said, I want to come back home. Caucasian, male or female, you're meeting your soul tribe family, okay, collective? Your miscarriage kid is up here, ready to reincarnate. Somebody here had a miscarriage, I'm sorry for your loss, or could have had an abortion. Take it how it resonates. When you get pregnant, that child will reincarnate, okay? If somebody got some wise advice about a soulmate connection, it's been a major shift, okay? Angel of romance, Cupid struck somebody in the ass, okay? Don't be concerned about the weapons formed against you. That shit weak anyways, period. Yeah, work for yourself. You're supposed to be a boss. Angel of strength, this has given you strength. Walking away has given you strength, okay? 9:44 on the clock, your soul plexus, and like I said, travel. I made the wrong decision. Somebody feel like they made the wrong decision. So maybe they gonna ask you to travel and like try to propose to you. It's opened by self-esteem, personal power, and confidence. It's blocked by low self-esteem, shame, and lack of agency. The affirmation for that is I have power over myself and my life. Say with me, I have power over myself and my life. 10:10 on the clock, completion. The color for that is yellow, okay? Spirit, what's this storm that's coming? Somebody, yeah, you completed something out. Good job. I'm so proud of y'all. My divine masculines, look at y'all. Okay. Oh. Okay, so somebody here is going towards a union, harmony, blessings from heaven. This is like free to indulge, or you could have thought something was this. Tens are very significant. Yeah, because karma. But really, they went towards a flighty energy, somebody that's in and out, like a player energy, and they got some type of justice, which they're going to take a leap of faith towards a twin flame, somebody that gives them true happiness. Pregnancy could be in the picture, or maybe somebody tried to keep somebody stuck with the pregnancy, but they're going towards their wish fulfillment. There's going to be a lot of celebrations, happiness going on. Yeah, this is, they're manifesting this. A high priestess? Don't play. They've been manifesting this. They have to stop and examine their life. This is like their ultimate wish fulfillment. Like, they're going to come in with a gift, free to indulge, spurs. Look, the lovers, the high priestess. I cannot make this up. They're gonna come in with like a gift, trying to be generous with you. They're going after somebody, their lover, somebody that's very intuitive. You could be a tarot reader, or they could have been at crossroads about lovers, and now they're going towards, yeah. Wow, this is pretty. Aww. Y'all gonna run up. Okay, look. Okay, well, it's the end of the situation, so let's see. Okay, so look, this is wish fulfillment, adulthood, childhood. This could have been somebody you with during adulthood, childhood. You're very intuitive. You're a divine feminine. Or that means things that still are going to be revealed, things that still to come. But they're going towards somebody for marriage. They were seeking some wise wisdom to go towards somebody that's their sunshine and their happiness. They want to work on, they're working on their coins, or they want to build with you. But look, this ended heartbreak. Devil obsession over the Empress, yeah. Or they were trying to keep the Empress tied to them. Or somebody said something about this, yeah, lies and illusions and deception. So somebody painted an illusion that this Empress was the devil, this intuitive person, and really it wasn't them. So this person could have talked about you a lot. Spirit, yeah. Control, materialism, and block and change. So that could be the major shift of everything that's coming out, and the true reason of why you're walking away. They see you now if they didn't see you then. Yeah, because they was fighty, they wanted to control the situation. They could have been very materialistic. But they were not trying to change. Spirit, what's this devil card? Because that's something that got people tied together too. Maybe they were trying to get you, keep you bonded to them, tied to them. Baby, heartstrings. Or maybe they thought they had the Empress. Let's see. What's this devil card, Spirit? Yeah. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Spirit. Yeah. So, okay, it was union, harmony, blessing. So you could have came into union with your divine partner. This had you, this was really in alignment with you. This is two of wands. This is a match your cup or your cup, okay, whatever the case may be. But there was a lot of lies and illusions projected. And they were investing in business. This is a business-oriented person. Or they were trying to paint illusions around your business. Yeah, because this is mastery of arts, crafts, and shifts. Get mastery of your coin. So maybe they were painting illusions around your business or saying false things or accusations about your business, which caused you to end this, which puts you in alignment. Yeah, battle between dark and light. You got power over this person. They're going to take a leap of faith towards this person that is a fierce lover. They love the idea of love. They fight for love. They're not materialistic. Okay, period. Collective, I see your divine masculine supply after what makes you happy. No more projecting shit, okay? Or maybe where they went, it was projected to them that that was their happiness and that really was not. Your ground. So maybe they stood tall. Okay, maybe somebody was talking about you. Like maybe they came towards somebody that was like, I want to go towards blase blase. And they were dogging you. And this person was standing up for you where they're being called to stand up for what they love. Take it how it resonates. Yeah, see beyond the current situation. They're seeing above the chaos now. They're being called to see above all the chaos, so then they'll see who the main messy corporate was and who's the one that's operating out of dark and light. Spirit, what would you advise divine masculines with this decision? See beyond the current situation. Like I said, you're being called to see above all the chaos that's going on because this person is telling you something about this intuitive person, and this intuitive person has pure intentions. So to say, retreat and recharge and follow the voice of your soul. Listen to your inner, internal being. Don't believe what the physical is showing you because people will sell you a dream if you allow them to. But spirit is telling you that your soul won't lie to you and people can't put dark magic on your heart nor soul. You need to get some rest and recharge yourself. You have not been resting. Yeah, wait for important information. So that's the storm that's coming. It's going to be some information that's going to come out. And spirit is telling you to be fearless and stand strong in this. It's going to be some information that comes out, which is going to make them see, like, what they thought was their happiness, their sunshine. And this is not that. Yeah. Learn from your spiritual experiences. Somebody here, you keep repeating the same lesson. You keep repeating the same pattern. Honor your inner knowing. It's like you're running from your inner knowing. And you keep bumping into karma. 1816 on the clock. 1818. So right here could be 18. It's like ignore your intuition just for that bitch to smack you back in your face. Like, damn, I should listen to my intuition. Yeah, trust your instincts. It's like you're getting gut feelings. You could be seeing deers here, white birds, shadow snakes. Oops, shadow skin. So look, you see this snake. You trying to hold on to snakes that's bringing you on this down narrow. And spirit is telling you, you need to get rid of any snakes that's nearby you. Because that's what's blocking your perspective. See, from a higher perspective, that's what's blocking your view. It's obstructing your view because you got a lot of snakes that you're trying to bring to the top with you. And spirit is like, no, what the hell? They happiness haters and you're trying to bring them to the top with you? Y'all like my pants? You're an angelic being, okay? You can't. Alpha be significant. Yeah, somebody here, you're in a testing stage. There are hidden cameras in your home. You're being very much watched. Somebody here is visualizing sex with you. They're doing sex magic on you. You're being tested, divine masculine. It's like with this information that you find out, what do you want to do? Or your divine feminines are in testing stage currently. Okay, spirit, what do you want to tell people? Yeah, lack mentality. Somebody here is operating out of lack. That could be anger. That could be fear. That could be shame. It's designed to keep you stuck. If I'm operating out of shame, regret, remorse, I will dance around accountability. I will avoid it. 2029 on the clock. 2031. Okay, so it's all about owning up to your shit and where you fell short at. And actually standing your ground. And you're actually showing that you mean what you're owning up to. Okay? Somebody here is dealing with a karmic feminine. That's why spirit said karmic and wrong. And this is a soul snatching spirit. And she's only there using you for your energy. She's there to take your soul. Okay? Her soul is the... She has the potential of being an earth angel, but she's not healed. Okay, secrets are coming out to heave to your surroundings. Yeah, it's going to be a lot of secrets hitting the surface. Lover plotting behind your back. You don't see that this person is plotting behind your back. It's karmic feminine. Wow. Air signs, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Water signs, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. Higher vibrations, raise your vibes. Like I said, if you're operating at a low vibrational energy, it's easier for demonic entities or deities to cling on to you. 2144 on the clock. Yeah, look, somebody here, you're a goddess. It's time for union in 3D. If they try to come in, they got a karmic feminine in the picture. So that's why spirit is telling you. No, they're going to try to bring you here for you to be in an entanglement. Take care of your body. How you expect to be productive if you don't replenish yourself? If you're not taking care of yourself, how do you expect to show up to work, show up to your arts, crafts, and shifts whole? Okay? It's not possible. You have to replenish yourself. You have to get rest. You have to give your body nutrition. Okay? Today I had a cheat day. I had a burger from McDonald's. And it had 333 on it and 111 on it. And 33. So them numbers can be significant. 2243 on the clock. Stop denying spiritual warfare. This shit real. Get in tune with self strengths and your gifts. Your ancestors want you to know that you are here denying spiritual warfare is real. And just because who these people are, you're not holding them accountable for their actions. You're not seeing them for their spirit. You more so recognizing them for their title. That you're not seeing the deceitful shit they doing to you. Yeah, Jezebel spirit. A demonic spirit that takes up residence in a person and causes them to be motivated by sexual desires. This body snatching spirit that you're around could be coming in your dreams, and they can disguise themselves as anybody. They can, once they lay down with you, it's easy for them to manipulate your dream field. This is a demonic spirit that maybe they touch you while you in your sleep. Wake you up to it. Take it how it resonates. This is a soul snatching spirit. So that's why spirit is like, no, why would I put you back around this person? And you're a high vibrational angelic being. And this person has this soul snatching spirit in his energy. They gonna be harboring both of y'all energy. Can't go to the light until you forgive me. Sorry, I attempted to backdoor you. Karma spent the buck. Somebody, this message has been coming up a lot. And maybe the message ain't get to the person that it needs to get to. Or maybe you don't know who it is, but they tried to backdoor you. And they genuinely cannot go to the light until you forgive them. B could be significant. Okay, somebody here is playing with the dead. Death spells. They're speaking death on a person's life. Wishing death on a person. Okay, doing graveyard magic, animal sacrifices. Somebody here is summoning up a demon that they're going to have to face. Or they're trying to send this to you because they know that you're operating at a low vibrational energy. 2443, so they feel as if it's going to attach to you easier. Make sure you're cleansing yourself. But you cannot be doing this because it's easier for the shit to jump in your body. Stop indulging in light and dark energy. Pick a side, no in between. It's like one day you want to be angelic. One day you want to be angelic, and then the next day you operating out of vindictive energy. Like, you need to make up your mind. 25:17 on the clock. 25:18. Can't go to the light till you forgive me from rape. I'm sorry, I was conditioned to think it was normal. So you got somebody here that needs forgiveness for trying to backdoor you, and then you have somebody here that needs forgiveness for somebody here that they got raped, and this could have been in a family home dynamic. They were conditioned to think that this was normal. So that means that they were being touched growing up. And then also the person that got backdoored, you got to think, why did they have a mentality of it's either eat what's on the plate or get ate? When you grow up around nothing but coyotes and leeches and wolves, what do you think that child is going to be a product of? Forgive them. I'm sorry I lied to you. I didn't want to hurt you. I knew it would and couldn't gather the words. Somebody here, they sorry that they lied to you. They could have been sick, or they could have knew that death was calling their name, and they didn't tell you. 26:24 on the clock, 26:25. So it's like, I don't know. I can't really tell you how to stomach, you know, grief, but I can tell you I don't speak on nothing I didn't go through. And with the rape thing, why would you allow somebody to take a piece for you? All they do is put you in a flashbacking mentality, a lack mentality. Forget this person, okay? Z could be significant. Y. Zy. And oh, love. Okay, spirit. Relationship color. Yeah, there are hidden cameras in your home. Collective. Stop thinking the grass green to follow your heart. So maybe somebody here really loves their old love. And this person's gonna come in with an offer, and maybe the spirit is telling you to follow your heart. Don't operate out of ego and pride if that's something that you really want. 27:31, 27:33. Control your anger. It's your biggest demise in the matrix program. Lucid dreams. This is something you're capable of. Yeah, getting readings about twin flame connection. Somebody here is getting readings about your twin flame dynamic. And maybe this is how this person knew or knows when this person is trying to come into this twin flame. There's a child involved in this. 12:12, big reunion energy. A path of spiritual growth, fulfillment of a sacred soul bond. You and your twin flame are about to cross paths in the physical realm. New beginning. Harmony, uniqueness, twin flame close within reach. So keep prospering, keep prevailing. Your twin flame is close. Somebody here, what did I say? Somebody here was faking a pregnancy. Maybe this is going to be the information that come out, and they're going to be like, oh, hell no. And that's going to make them go to their twin flame. Because that's what they really love, but they were only sticking around because this person was saying you're pregnant. 4:44:44. Good times are coming. You should expect a change in fortunes. Positive changes is coming. Twin flames are on the same wavelength. Twin flame mirroring each other. A calm, stable relationship coming into fruition. This is somebody that's on their twin flame relationship. Earth angel healer. Your earth angel healer. Your community union with your twin flame. Stay at a calm, stay at a bond. Keep prevailing, keep growing, keep working on your coin. And this could lead to marriage, possibly. Somebody gonna find out somebody here faking a pregnancy. Yeah. A child involved. Temple of Truth. You the Temple of Truth. Tarot reader. R could be significant. R. G. S. Look, rushing in after a storm. Somebody here, you speak nothing but the truth. You stand tall, even if you gotta be by yourself. 29:37, 29:39. Matrix programming. Yeah, this is going to bring about the matrix programming. 12:12, reunion energy. Secured involved. They keep seeing signs of you. Stop thinking the grass greener. Follow your heart. Can't nobody do dark magic on your heart or your soul. There's something with a kid that got this person stuck, okay? Sacrificing for twin flame behind. Sacrificing for twin flame relationship behind the scenes. This person is sacrificing. This person gonna try to lay down with you on their period to keep you stuck. 222. Your soulmate is trying to connect with you. If you are already in a relationship that's committed, it indicates that your partner is your soulmate. And together you'll bring something fresh into existence. Also, a number for self-love, higher vibrations. Domesticated and nurturing. Attract Cancer or Taurus, or this could be what you are. 111. New love is coming. A fresh start is on its way to you. A new beginning. You could attract an Aries, Cancer, Libra, or Capricorn. The paradox of love. So somebody here is on their self-love journey. Somebody here is on their soulmate journey. And somebody here is on their twin flame journey. Self-love journey is mandatory. Setting boundaries if you're unwilling or unable to be vulnerable. We lose courage to embrace the joy of love. We only love others at the capacity we love ourselves. The paradox of individuality, becoming whole with self, knowing thyself. The body has either X and Y or XX chromosomes. And this is also teaching you to control your sexual urges, okay? This is teaching you semen retention because it's easier for soul-snatching spirits to get onto you if you're thinning yourself out. You're thinning your energy out throughout different people and energies. So you're picking up people demons along the way of battling your own. Sexually transmitted demons. It's not just diseases that you have to worry about. So the person is facing hard slander, abandonment, rejection, abuse, and they never healed it, sexual abuse, and they never healed it. You are getting demons and passing them on as you're going to, and getting more, obtaining more, and you're battling your own. And wonder why you wake up and you in a fear mentality. That's not your energy. Then you're feeling your twin energy too. Okay. Spirit, what do you want to advise the Divine Masculine? Write it on the top. Thank you. Okay. Spiritually, the idolization of, what are you idolizing spiritually? It's like something that you look at and it's an idol. It probably motivates you. It inspires you. But mentally, confusion regarding. But what are you mentally confused about? It's like you idolize it spiritually, but in your head it's telling you something completely different. It's like you can't see no other way around it, but something spiritually you're idolizing. And physically, in the physical, what do you have to sacrifice to get this that you idolize? Okay? Or what sacrifices are you willing to make to obtain this that you want here? Okay, Capricorn is out, Neptune, Uranus, and Venus. Okay, dedication to achieve what spiritually? What are you dedicated to achieve on a spiritual level that you're going to have to make sacrifices to get there? Mentally, what are you focusing on mentally? Like I said, you've been reminiscing about this. It's like it's all in your head, all in your heart, all in your soul, but you're trying to convince your head that it's not true. Okay, physically, resulting from the rules imposed by. What limitation, what rules are you putting on yourself? It's like saying, oh, I can't do it. Knowing that you can, it's like putting a limit on your growth. And then spirit is going to show you exactly what you manifested. Okay? Spiritually, an unusual example of, what are you being called to lead by example on? Maybe you come from a dynamic where they all do the same thing, the same repeated pattern. And you're supposed to be the unusual one. You're supposed to be the one that stands out, that do something different. Okay? And mentally, a different way of looking at, what perception are you looking at this thing that you idolize? It's like you idolize it, but then you're looking at it in a whole different perception mentally. But on a spiritual level, on a soul level, you want this. Okay? And physical and unexpected change. Where the unexpected will show up for you in your physical, but what steps are you willing to take in your mental, spiritual, physical, 34, 54 on the clock, okay? Spiritually, your destiny. It's the destiny of fate. Is this planned out? Is this a path that you want to take? Okay? Mentally, where you're going. It's like mentally, you're thinking about, okay, destiny is going to bring me here. Maybe you're a person that plans everything out, and you got to see everything to face value. You got to see it right in front of you. And spirit is like, just take the destiny and see where it leads you. Okay? And physically, your career. This could be about a career. Physically, what does your career say about you as a person? What are you doing with your career? How are you improving yourself? You're only in competition with yourself, okay? So how are you bettering yourself throughout the years as far as your career and things that you want to do and places that you see yourself being, okay, collective? Are you sitting in rooms with people that got the same career of where you see yourself going, of where you want to go? Are you in rooms with people that got mentalities that fit the role of you seeing yourself in the future? Or are you just hanging with the low bottom group because they tolerate you? 36:13, okay? Cherish. This is an action. What do you need to cherish on a spiritual level? How are you expressing gratitude? Okay, collective. Mentally enjoy. It's like you enjoy this mentally. When you reminisce, it's like you're smiling. You got love on the brain. You're just thinking like, it makes you happy. Okay? And physically, charm, art, and beauty are the way too. Are you using your art, your beauty, your looks to get what you want? Or are you using your talents to take this approach in? Like if you're artistic, draw something. Are you using your gifts to do this? Or are you more so using your gifts in the good way or in the bad, negative intent? Okay? Okay, collective, let's do some affirmations. Ooh, and let me get y'all these zodiac signs, because I always do this. Yeah, my ancestors left me another feather today in the driveway. So cute. Okay, am I ready? Okay, let me see. One more. Okay. Okay, so we got Neptune, so... Neptune is Pisces rising, is compassion, imagination, dream, spirituality, and where you can be deceived. Where are you easily deceived at spiritually as well? Like, can somebody come in and talk you out your path, and it's the people that's closest to you, and that's where they can deceive you, that it can make you go completely a whole different way of what you know, 38:38 on the clock. Okay, and that is Pisces ruling. We got Uranus out. Uranus is Aquarius ruling. Your originality, innovation, life force, rebellious nature, where the unexpected may show up for you. Like I said, 38:58, it's like trying to convince yourself on a physical level that something you feel on a soul level is not true. And then listening to the influences that's also around you as well, on something that you know on a soul level, something that you originally came from, something that you reincarnated for. And innovating your life, taking charge of your own life. Uranus was that one. We got Venus out as well. Venus is Taurus and Libra rising. The color for that is green and pink. The card is green. The card is the Empress card in Cooper. Love, beauty, relationship, attraction, pleasure, and money. It's your love language and what you appreciate. So this is something that you feel on a soul level, but it's like I said, it's like your physical is telling you something different, or something that you feel on a soul and a mental level, and you think back and reflect on this all the time. But it's like convincing yourself it's not that, because it's your mentality. 4014 on the card. So somebody here needs to do some renovation of their mind's mentality. And what are you willing to sacrifice? I send a prayer of love to all beings in need of a miracle. Say it with me. I send a prayer of love to all beings in need of a miracle. My greatest experience of freedom comes when I let go of what others think of me. My greatest experience of freedom comes when I let go of what others think of me. You care about what this person thinks. You're looking for their approval. That's where the limitation come from. It's like trying to blend in and fit in and have a baddest female on your arm just to impress other people. And it's like, does that make you happy for real? Or do you still feel empty? Because when that wheel dries up, where do you think that female gonna go? If it's not love. Every cell in my body is consciousness, is conscious and communicates with each positive thought I have. Say it with me. Every cell in my body is conscious and communicates with each positive thought I have. I celebrate my progress. Awareness, not perfection, is the goal. Say it with me. I celebrate my progress. Awareness, not perfection, is the goal. When I see good in others, I acknowledge it out loud. Say it with me. When I see good in others, I acknowledge it out loud. I know that's right. Uplifting. I can't control the world, but I can control how I choose to perceive it. Say it with me. I can't control the world, but I can control how I choose to perceive it. Somebody here needs to take control of their own life, because it's like somebody is telling you one thing and to look at something in one way, and it's completely different. But you're allowing them to control your mentality. Especially if it's a twin flame dynamic. You know how people come up against a twin flame dynamic? 42, 44 in the park. People be watching, like, people spiritually and knowing something for them. And to come in and take it, because they want that destiny. Okay. Restitution, find stolen objects and discover the person's responsible. Look, I told you, people be coming in wanting people destinies. You see how it's a dude, angel, it's a female, or is that a, no, that's a male. Yeah, somebody here came in. I'm sorry, my kid collected my phone, died, but somebody here came in here, tried to steal somebody else's destiny right underneath their nose. That was the black magic. They were like, okay, this person fits my destiny more, so I'm trying to keep them on my path instead of my twin flame, or instead of my soulmate type of energy. Spirit was like, no, 22 on the clock, so maybe that's the storm that's coming. Okay, submission to higher order identifies traitors and destroys their plans. Yeah, somebody here was about to, they was gonna play this in into the grave, okay? And they was the ones that was stirring the pot behind the scene, and that's why Spirit is like, look above the situation. Knowledge of good and evil appeases divine anger and cures ellipses. Yeah. Spirit is not playing. Somebody here has, it's like trying to put somebody down. Say they like a fraud. Oh, you ain't intuitive. Oh, they not intuitive as you think they is. Like, they lying. I saw blah, 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 lying through their teeth. And then, I don't know. It's like making a deal. And then, or like trying to put somebody on with somebody to make them walk away from something. 69, 33, 66, and 61. okay? Affinity and friendships, attain the friendship of anyone. And it's like you're trying to keep a friendship with this person. It's friendship, broship, sistership, whatever ship. And this person is don't want to see you happy. See how this person got them down? I don't know. Yeah, desire to know, the acquisition of wisdom. And it's like you're looking for answers. You're looking for more knowledge, 62, before you make a concrete decision. Or you just really like learning wisdom. Discernment. General prosperity. The deliverance of prisoners. Okay, so somebody here was trying to get you put in jail. Maybe they could have been calling the police on you or doing things to try to get you locked up. But if you innocent, you gonna prevail. Like, it's gonna seep through. Redemption serves against enemies of religion, governs chastity. And you got people that's religious. So that's why evil tarot / religious person came out. This is somebody that could be religious or a religious tarot reader. And the intentions is not pure. It's like this is a person that manipulates scriptures to their own liking. So it's to their own benefit. And it's like, well, this. Or they say, well, in the Bible, it say, spirituality is witchcraft, it's demonic, but they don't know nothing about it nor learn anything or walk that path type of energy. Mission protects against slander and impetuous people. What did I say? Somebody slandering somebody because of what they believe, how they look. It's just slandering everything about a person, trying to annihilate their character just so you'll be chosen. Mental force protects against sorrows and illness. They want you sick. They could be sending you sickness magic. Like, they do not want this person to pick you. 41, 62, 57, and 20 is down. Then I got 22 right here. Fame and renown, influences, converges, voyages, and great discoveries. Look, what did I say? Like, crucifying somebody, put somebody on the cross and burnt their head. They were trying to annihilate a person. Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 6, 7. It could have been 7 people. They was trying to crucify them, like, really come at a person mad. But this only made that person stronger. It was like, instead of letting this make me weak, I'm going to grow up out of this. I'm going to become strong. How can I turn this into healing information? My life experiences, instead of putting the next person down. Let me get y'all some shadow work. Yeah, be patient. Trust the way everything is coming together. All this had to happen to let go. Let me see what song was next. YouTube, I do not own copyright to this music. Okay, what am I grateful for right now, and am I focused on what I'm gaining or losing? Okay, let me be patient, trust the way everything is coming together. Yeah. But you need to believe in this, and maybe you've been called to stand up and stand tall on what you really want. Adopt an abundance mindset. Gratitude is the antidote to all your problems. It is impossible to be fearful and grateful at the same time. Gratitude improves our health, opens our hearts, and changes our state. The universal law of attraction says that we attract into our lives that which we are focused. Close your eyes, put your hand on your heart, and think of 3 things you're grateful for today. Embrace what you've learned and cherish your experiences because they're divinely fated. This is fated. So enjoy the destiny. How can I infuse more self-love and compassion into my life? what boundaries need to be created or strengthened within my relationships. The sacrifice you make today will be worth it. To rise, you must let go of fear. Somebody, you got some money coming, divine inheritance, unexpected money. You could wake up rich, okay? You got money coming in. It's gonna come in short amount or small amount. Somebody here is watching on fake accounts, friends accounts. They hiding behind accounts. Yeah, divorce, breakup, final, because they're gonna break up, or they broke up, or they trying to make sure that they don't come towards you. Yeah, it resonates. When I say copycat, they telepathically communicating, they were having dreams and songs with this person. Everything around them is falling apart, and they feel sad, crushed, and broken. Ever since they started messing with this person. And if it's not that, it's just, yeah, copycat. Maybe they compromise with a copycat. Surprise event coming. Don't get a room, hotel, motel, Airbnb. Yeah, it compromised with this copycat. Hotel, motel, suite, Airbnb is going to be a physical fight. This could be arguments at war, competing, or it's competition going on around them. Breaking point, which is going to push them to their breaking point. Verge about to confess something, or something's going to be revealed. And they're focused on you. They may be that they really like you and they really only got eyes for you is going to be revealed. And that they're watching you look twin flames. They're going to give you a dirty offer. Emotion coming in going. Somebody here found everything pop out. You feel like this old news. Journal more, okay, y'all. They gonna try to come in and bargain with this boss ass bitch. Stalking them. Recording announcement express and revealing something. Yeah, this is a dirty offer. 911 on the clock. This is a dirty offer. They're messing with somebody. Maybe somebody got money. Yeah, trash, disregard. Unconditional love, or maybe it's a karmic still here. So they're gonna come in trying to offer something. It's gonna be a dirty offer, okay? Or maybe this is the storm that's gonna hit and they're gonna realize that this person gave them a dirty offer. Let's see. Yeah. Court paperwork filed. It's gonna be something in court that comes out. Anything else? Divorce, breakup, contract, final. Something gonna come out in court that's gonna make them split. You can go towards this divine connection. They're fishing for comments about this connection. Make sure you guys are protecting yourself sexually, 10, 11 on the clock, or they're protecting their sexual energy now, or this is you. Yeah, financial support, child alimony, or something with a kid, court. Government fighting for what you lost spiritually. Love is a battlefield. Announcement and expression. Yeah, they're gonna come in and compromise with this person. But these girl fights, this is gonna be too much around them. They're gonna just be like, oh my god, like, they're not signing up for this shit for real. Okay, spirit. Yeah, game over. This shit over with. The door opened. They trying to survive, make their money, maybe this copycat. A breakup gonna come, confirmation. I'm telling you, burning evidence. They gonna try to get rid of some evidence. Ooh, caught a case, look. Caught a case, sexual infection, disease, rash. That's why they trying to get them in the hotel 1113 so they can lay down. They probably know they got something and they trying to get this person something. Cause they know this person is single, or this is you. forbidden love. Mm-hmm. Cautious. They scared. They panicking. This is a powerful letter. Both of y'all want 11:30, 5:20, 7:41, 8. Money comes to me 3x3. You got finances coming in, okay? Yeah, something with kids involved. Women and a copycat. It's like somebody's trying to act like they're a divine feminine. So yeah, I resonate. Okay, let me get y'all over some songs and nothing get about here. 11:51 on the clock. That was on my receipt this morning. You know, my body got Drake Dow and Capella Gray. Maybe they mess with somebody that they know their body. You know what to do. I Hate It Here, Part 2 by Crack White. Okay, Spirit. The Business by Kasha Berg. Sex Therapy by Robin Thicke. Statue by Lil Eddie. You See Me Swinging by Mid Condition. 12:27 o'clock. That's been coming on Spotify so much for me. So that heavy on that song. Do Too Much by Amarae the Great. This just came on today. Incomplete by Cisco. How to Love by Lil Wayne. Confessions by Usher. Spirit, you give me two more songs. How to Love by Lil Wayne. Say Goodbye by Chris Brown. Confessions by Usher, Fantio, Freestyle by Mona Lisa, and You See Me Swinging by Mint Condition. All right, collective key, collective. Let me cleanse y'all out. Okay. My divine guides, guardian angels, my ancient Egyptian ancestors, and my Indian ancestors, I ask that you cleanse us out and cleanse out any negative energy. I ask that you expose the enemy's plans before they even take off the ground. Do not allow them to prevail nor seep through. Any blockages placed upon the collective, I ask that you put a red, white veil light of protection over them and allow them to keep prevailing on their journeys and allow these plans to see through before they take off. You guys need to stop hearing what people think. Side note. I ask that you, any hexes, curses, spells, binds, evil eye, dark magic, cloak, spells, confusion, trickery sent in to keep the collective stuck, stagnant, or distracted, I ask that you transmute to love, light, and healing energy and release it and keep them on their proper clear-cut paths or lead them to their proper paths. Even these karmics, lead them to some healing. Thank you, my spirit guides, my angels, my divine guides, and my ancestors. I ask that you cleanse out the video and any blockages placed upon or projections placed upon my collective. Thank you. All right, spiritual gang, love, namaste, and I'm out. See you, collective.